absorbed into mid-caps worth 4,396 and 29,306 in small caps. My God, I'm sure with this, someone might have missed a heartbeat. Are these big numbers? These seem to be big numbers. There is a big sell-off from large caps. What will happen? Do you think this can be one of the reasons why Nifty can crash? Maybe? This can be coupled up with the China-India tensions which are going on the border right now. Number two. Number three, US elections coming up. If it has a negative impact, if it goes against what was expected, three big reasons why market can fall. Semicircular, wherein 33,000 crore worth money can go out from large caps. From large caps, majorly Nifty stocks. Second, as I mentioned, geopolitical tensions. And number three, the US presidential elections. So what can be the next thing which can happen? The whole purpose of doing this video is not to scare you away, but to make you understand that these are not big numbers. I will say, Rachna, are you going mad? You said right now 33,000 crore rupees is going to be sold off from large caps. Now understand the magnitude of that. Is that a big number? No, that's not a big number. Why? Now, I also tried to take out the data. How much is the total equity mutual funds AUM? Okay, total AUM of equity mutual funds is 7,69,000 crores. Now compare this 33,000 crores with 7,69,000 crores. This is just a 4.38%. Now compare this figure of 33,000 crores of outflow from large caps to the total AUM in the mutual fund industry right now. Total AUM of mutual fund industry right now is somewhere around 27,49,000 crores. So it is just 1.22% of the AUM. Isn't that way too small? Yes. So the whole purpose of making this video is that there might be some videos which might tell you, oh my God, can this lead to a next big crash? See the figures. These are not very big figures. 33,000 crores. If you check only in singularity, it's a big number. But if you try to compare it with something, these are like just 4% of the total AUM of equity mutual fund and only 1.2% of the total AUM. Okay, so not a big thing. Then I'll try to give you one more data. Just for you to tell, is that a really big data? What we did was, we also tried to check out from the AMFI website, how much was the net outflow? What is net outflow? How much was invested in mutual fund and how much went out of mutual funds in the month of August 2020? The net outflow from the mutual fund industry was 14,500 crores. Outflow, I'm saying, in August only. Did that lead to a big crash in August? No, in fact, markets have been moving up. Okay? So, don't worry, these are not very big numbers. Now, the last question to be answered. Do mutual funds have any solution for this, number one? And as an investor, what should I do? Two things. Understand. What can mutual funds do with this? Mutual funds, possibility number one, they can do a rebalancing, which I talked about right now. Sell 33,000 crore worth. I just gave you an example. Worth that much money, they'll sell off from large cap, they'll invest in mid-cap and small caps. Okay. Possibility number two, what is there? Possibility number two is that they can recategorize this fund into some other category. For example, I've talked about one mutual fund right now, if I'm not mistaken, that was the Kotak mutual fund. Yes, Kotak mutual fund, Kotak multi-cap, which was 72% was in large cap. They just need to put 8 more percent so that they can convert this multi-cap fund into a large cap fund. Okay? Or Motilal Oswal, though, anywhere it is 86%, but Motilal Oswal multi-cap 35 is 86% in equity right now. So they can also categorize large cap equity. They can also get recategorized as a large cap fund. Very, very, very important point coming up here. What is that? A single mutual fund house can have only one mutual fund